long blood between me and you.
Hey, fuck has a branding iron! Fire in the eye!
Straight edge means I am better than
you.
Why do the extreme horsemen hold all the gold?
Oh my god!
They just hit him with a broomstick!
Oh no, no, no!
Oh! I'm witnessing pro wrestling. It's nothing but a fight.
I am the best in this generation.
And this should be a classic. The extreme chairman, La Parca, versus the hardcore hero, Sabu. Well, that certainly sets the tone for this matchup, doesn't it? La Parca is not intimidated by Sabu. Bill Alfonso, the manager of champions, in Sabu's corner. Referee John Finnegan officiating this matchup. Again, an example of what sets Major League Wrestling apart. The diversity of the wrestling in MLW. Lucha Libre, Japanese strong style, traditional, and yes, extreme wrestling. And I'd be lying to you if I told you I didn't have a soft spot in my heart for extreme wrestling. Sabu misses with the chair. La Parca certainly has got inside the head of Sabu. The question is, can he deal with what he's found in there? Sabu, the nephew of the one, the only, the original fireball-throwing Sheik. Sabu's in the best shape I have ever seen him in. Of course, Sabu made a name for himself in ECW Extreme Championship Wrestling, but quite frankly, is in better shape now than he was then, and he's a smarter wrestler now than he was then. Back in the glory days of ECW, Sabu would throw caution to the wind for no reason at any time during a matchup, causing himself as much harm, sometimes more, than his opponent. Sabu now older, wiser, and more dangerous, more methodical, has integrated more ground wrestling, more submission wrestling into his matches. Now when Sabu goes to the air, he's going for the kill, and it makes him all the more dangerous. Look at the shape that Sabu's in. Waistlock takedown by La Parca. Sabu now, nice reversal. Floats over to Sabu, lateral press. Tip up by La Parca. There's a side of both athletes most fans don't know about. Sabu and La Parca can wrestle on the mat. Catch-as-catch-can style in both of their repertoire. Waistlock takedown into the camel clutch by Sabu. Referee John Finnegan is right there. Parca finds the way out by grabbing the leg of Sabu, going for a reversal now. Yes, he's got a camel clutch of his own. How insulting for Sabu. Sabu now with both legs finds a way out, looking for the leg submission of his own. La Parca, both hands full of hair. Reversal out of the corner. La Parca hits hard. Sabu now launches himself. Slingshot sidekick along with the slingshot leg drop. 2.5. Vintage Sabu. And back to the camel clutch. Sabu wearing down La Parca. Alfonso right there. The manager of champions, the coach, Bill Alfonso. Boot right to the face. Laparca charges, catches an elbow, rolls through it, nicely done. Sunset flip, Laparca, both boots in the face of Sabu. Two, foot across the bottom rope. Excellent game of human chess we are seeing right now between the hardcore hero Sabu and the extreme chairman Laparca. Sabu being set up on the top turnbuckle. Sabu and Laparca exchanging blows. Laparca going all the way up top. Laparca shoved off, lands on his feet though. Sabu now to the outside. Tornado DDT is blocked by Laparca. Clothesline sends Sabu back in the ring. Up and over goes Laparca, misses the slingshot. Somersault senton, Sabu now with the leaping tornado DDT spikes Laparca. Both Sabu and Laparca down. Lateral press, two, and you can hear the coach Bill Alfonso at ringside shouting instructions to Sabu. And the coach Bill Alfonso deserves a lot of the credit for Sabu being a more complete wrestler now than he had been in his earlier years. Nice sidestep by Sabu, looking for another DDT. But there's the spinning leg kick. The heel caught Sabu right in the face. The coach Alfonso tells Sabu to roll to the outside. He does, but Laparca gives chase. Up and over goes Sabu into the first row. Take a wrestler home night here in Fort Lauderdale. Sabu got his hands up. I'm not sure what good that did him though. Sabu hits that steel guardrail, that unforgiving steel guardrail. Laparca now going up top. He's airborne. Laparca pulling out all the stops to prove that he is the king of extreme. Laparca now setting up a table. That does not bode well for Sabu, although Laparca has done his homework. That may backfire on him as it has on so many previous opponents of Sabu. The table is in play. Sabu trying to fight his way back into the ring. Laparca will not let him. Bullseye with the chair. Sabu falls to the floor, manages to avoid the table. Sabu, ever the veteran, knew where he was in relation to the table, even when getting his brain scrambled. Laparca now with a full head of steam, waiting on Sabu. Oh my God! The table breaks, but even worse, perhaps the femur of Laparca did as well. Holy shit. Parka clutching at his left leg. Believe he damn near sailed over the table into the steel guardrail, and Sabu has the spike. No, it's a pair of scissors. Oh my God, he's stabbing away at the skull of LaParka. He's carving into the mask, into the flesh of LaParka. LaParka trying to fight off the scissors and trying to keep his mask on. It's double jeopardy for LaParka. Sabu just stabbing away, poking holes in the mask, poking holes in the flesh of LaParka's face. Oh my God! LaParka now thrown over that steel guardrail. The bloodied face of LaParka showing through that ripped, torn mask. There's the assist from Coach Alfonso. Keep your eye on Sabu. Oh my God! Again, the more complete Sabu, the older, wiser Sabu, throwing caution to the wind when he feels he can go for the kill. We've never seen any of LaParka's face before. Quite frankly, the only thing protecting LaParka's identity right now is his own blood. LaParka losing a lot of blood. Very slow to get up. This is a matchup that LaParka will never forget. Win, lose, or draw, LaParka will never forget the night he squared off against Sabu in Major League Wrestling. Sabu looking to put away LaParka. LaParka kicks out, his blood now staining the mat. Right hand connects. LaParka is taking a beating at the hands of Sabu. And again, Sabu with the scissors carving the face of LaParka. Damn near taking his eye out of his head. Oh my God. How much more blood can LaParka stand to lose? Sabu with the miscue and LaParka capitalizes. Cover, two, no. Got to give credit to LaParka for trying to put away Sabu. Lesser men bleeding like that with their flesh torn open would pack it in, would walk away, would take the count out loss. But not LaParka. He wants to be the king of extreme. Sabu tied to the tree of woe, steel chair in his face. And LaParka drives it home. Cover! Sabu kicks out.
Sabu, big move. Stop him, Sabu. Stop him with the parking thing. Anything, stop.
Park it out. Looking at his own blood, smearing his own blood on his wrestling tights. LaParka almost drawing motivation from seeing his own blood. And Sabu giving as good as he gets. This matchup has become a war of attrition. whoever survives this matchup will be the winner and will be the king of extreme. Sabu set for the ride. Laparca charges, misses, hits the steel ring post. I have never, repeat, never seen Laparca take a beating like the beating he is taking at the hands of Sabu. Sabu up and over and again knew exactly when to launch himself at Laparca for maximum impact. There is not much left of Laparca's mask. He's trying to keep the remnants of that mask in place to hide his identity. The blood flowing down his face is also doing that for Laparca. Coach Alfonso brings over the table, sets it up. Sabu lays out Laparca. There's the chair from Alfonso. Laparca being held in place by his hair. Oh my God! Laparca is in a bad way, and referee John Finnegan does not have the authority to stop this matchup. This is an extreme wrestling matchup. It will continue until one competitor is pinned, submits, or is just knocked cold. Coach Alfonso pours some cold water over Sabu to revitalize him. He is invaluable at ringside. Laparca's a mess. Laparca's blood still flowing heavily from his forehead, and it's flowing everywhere. God. He can't even stand up. He's taken a vicious beating. He's lost so much blood. Laparca rolls back into the ring, which is a very brave thing to do, and kicks out. There are no countouts. There are no disqualifications. This is an extreme wrestling matchup. Pinfalls, submissions, or a knockout. Will Laparca give it up to the Camel Clutch? He's beaten. He's battered. He's bloody. Scooping a slam on Laparca by Sabu. Sabu going up top. Gets caught. Both feet in the face. And of sheer instinct, sheer desperation, Laparca, through the torn mask, through the blood running into his eyes, was able to see Sabu coming down from the top turnbuckle and get the boots up. Can Laparca capitalize? He hooks the leg. No, Sabu kicks out. Laparca attempting to mount the comeback. His own blood stains the ring canvas, stains the ringside area, stains his own wrestling tights. And despite that, Laparca is going up top. But no, he can't maintain his balance. He gets caught and crushed by Sabu. Carefully measured right hands by Sabu. Sabu takes over Laparca. Cover. No, Laparca kicks out. There's the chair once again from Coach Alfonso. Arabian face buster. Cover. LaParca kicks out again. Sabu has got to be thinking to himself, what in the hell do I have to do to put away LaParca? How about the triple jump moonsault? Will that get it done? Yes! Sabu remains the king of extreme, but there is nothing I wouldn't do to see an extreme wrestling rematch between these two gladiators, Sabu and LaParca. And you can bet the Major League Wrestling fans will demand it as well. Oh my God, what a war that was! And Coach Alfonso sending some assistance to LaParca, who has rejected it. LaParca now back to his feet. And Sabu showing a very rare sign of respect to an opponent in LaParca. Will LaParca accept the hand of Sabu? He does. And LaParca raises the hand of Sabu. Sabu does the same for LaParca. Mutual respect being shown. These two must meet again.